Hello children, today we are going to start a new poem from your 8th standard English book, A Thing of Beauty. A Thing of Beauty is a poem is written by famous romantic poet John Keats. This poem tells about how nature and its wonders mesmerize us and take away all the sorrows that surround us from time to time. Come, let's enter into this poem. Hello children, today we are going to start a new poem from your 8th standard English book, A Thing of Beauty. Children, do you admire the beauty of nature, animals, people, places or things? Discuss with your friends. Let's see about the author. John Keats, 1795 to 1821, was a British romantic poet. Although trained to be a surgeon, Keats decided to devote himself wholly to poetry. Keats' secret, his power to sway and delight the readers, lies primarily in his gift for perceiving the world and living his moods and aspirations in terms of language. A Thing of Beauty is an excerpt from his poem, Endymion, a poetic romance. The poem is based on a Greek legend in which Endymion, a beautiful young shepherd and poet who lived on Mount Latmos, had a vision of Cynthia, the moon goddess. The enchanted youth resolved to seek her out and so wandered away through the forest and down under the sea. Let's read the poem, A Thing of Beauty. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower quiet for us and a sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. Therefore, on every morrow are we wreathing a flowery band to bind us to the earth. Some shape of beauty moves away the pall. From her dark spirits, such the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon for simple sheep and such hot daffodils. With the green world they live in, and clear rills that for themselves a cooling covert make, gains the hot season, the mid of forest break, rich with a sprinkling of fair musk, rose blooms, an endless fountain of immortal drink, pouring unto us from the heaven's brink, by John Keats. Let's see the explanation of this poem. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness. According to the poet, a thing of beauty is a joy forever. From the above lines, the poet says that a beautiful thing is a source of endless joy. It has eternal beauty, which never fades away. Here the word eternal means lasting or existing forever without end, but will keep a bower quiet for us and a sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. Here the poet explains that a beautiful thing is like a shady shelter which gives us a sleep full of sweet dreams, good health and relaxation. Therefore, on every morrow are we wreathing a flowery band to bind us to the earth. Here we can able to see the wreath. Wreath means an arrangement of flowers, leaves or stems fastened in a ring and used for decoration or for laying on a grave. The poet says our attachment to the earthly things are like a flowery wreath They are traps which bind us to the materialistic things and keep us away from eternal happiness. Some shape of beauty moves away the pall from our dark spirits. From the above lines, the poet explains that the earth is full of hatred, greed, and negativity. According to the poet, the gloom and sadness caused by this negativity fade away with the positive vibes of the beautiful things that surround us. Here the word vibes means a person's emotional state or the atmosphere of a place as communicated to and felt by others. Such, the sun, the moon, tree hold and hang, sprouting a shady boon for simple sheep. The poet lists out some of the beautiful things that surround us. As the saying goes, lies in the eyes of the beholder, says that the numerous creations of God, like the sun which gives us energy, the moon's beauty, the trees which gives us shade, or the natural beauties around us, the various animals like the sheep that surround us, make our world lively. And such hot daffodils, with the green world they live in, and clear rills that for themselves a cooling covert make, joins the hot season. From the above lines, the poet says that the pretty flowers like daffodils make the world green and lively. The flowing streams of water cool and refresh us in the hot summer season. The mid-forest brake, rich with a sprinkling of fair musk, rose blooms, an endless fountain of immortal drink, pouring unto us from the heaven's brink. From the above lines, the poet says, the forests which are full of the pretty musk rose flowers are a beautiful sight to the eye. All these are the things of beauty, also the stories of the brave soldier who laid their lives to protect their people are beautiful and inspiring. These beautiful things are like a fountain of immortality bestowed upon us by God. They inspire us to live on and maintain our faith in goodness. Let's see the glossary. Bower, shelter under the shade of trees, wreathing, cover, surround, encircle something, pall, covering, rills, clear stream, sprinkling, falling in fine drops. Let's see the rhyming words from this poem. Forever, never, keep, sleep, breathing, wreathing, moon, boon, daffodils, rills, make, break, drink, brink. Now we'll see the figure of speech, alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of the same consonant letters or similar sounds at the beginning words in a set or series of words. For example, wild, wind, curious, clock, splendid, scholar, memorable, moments, creepy, crawlies. What is imagery? Imagery is the way that a writer helps read or visualize or see in their minds what is being described. These images often suggest emotions. Images appeal to one or more of the five senses are sight, hearing, touch, taste, or smell. That five senses are auditory. It describes what we hear: music, noise, silence. Visual describes what we see. For example, colors, patterns, shapes, size. Tactile describes what we touch or feel. For example, texture, movement, temperature. Olfactory describes what we smell: nice fragrances, bad odors. gustatory. Describes what we taste. Sour, sweet, acidic, bitter, salty. Let's see the examples of the five sense. Sight. The tiny red ant climbed up the broken twig. Smell. The sweet smell of freshly baked apple filled the air. Taste. One bite of the sour lemon caused my lips to pucker. Sound. The car squawked every time I hit a bump in the road. And finally, touch. The sharp edge of the paper cut my finger and made it sting.